Hello, this is Mohsin. I welcome you in the next financial accounting class. I hope you are learning from VSSS Virtual Student Support Services YouTube channel and the financial accounting class. Before starting our today's class, I would like to review the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about the assets, liabilities, owner equity and financial equation or accounting equation. In our today's session, we have talked about the accounting equation which we have discussed in the previous lecture. But now, in our today's session, we take an example and try to solve it with you. In the last, we have also described the rules for debit and credit. Before starting our today's session, I would like to share a beautiful quote with you, that is, life is like accounting, everything must be balanced. This quotation is written by an anonymous author. It will increase the importance of financial accounting in our life. With this quotation, we have start our today's session. As we have discussed that we have take an example of accounting equation in this session and solve it. The illustration is, show the effect of the following transaction upon the accounting equation. For the month of June, first transaction is Mr. Charlie started his business with $100,000. The next transaction is purchase furniture for $4,000. Next, purchase goods for $25,000. On the 10th June, paid transportation on goods purchased $1,000. On 12th June, sold goods for $15,000, costing $11,000. And 15th of the June, purchase goods on credit basis for $15,000. 19th June, sold goods to Mr. Raza on credit basis for $8,000, costing $6,500. 25th, received cash from Rashid, $4,000. 28th June, cash paid to creditor, $9,000. 30th of this month, paid rent and salary for the month of June, $4,000. Now we have seen that how to solve this illustration in the accounting equation. So we have an accounting equation that is, asset is equal to liabilities plus owner equity. We have first transaction, Mr. Charlie started his business with $100,000. Now we have seen that how to put this transaction into the accounting equation, that is, asset is equal to liabilities plus owner equity. In the left side, asset, we have written cash. Cash is belong to the asset. In the right side of accounting equation, we have liabilities and owner equity is written. We have right capital and owner equity. In the left side, we have written $100,000. On the right side, in below the capital, we have also written in the capital $100,000. Because every debit is equal to every credit, and we have also known that assets is equal to liabilities plus owner equity. It means our left hand side is equal to almost right hand side. So the first transaction is written. The second transaction is he purchased furniture for $4,000. Now we have open an other account named as furniture account in the left hand side, below the asset side, and put the value of $4,000. But on the right hand side, we have nothing to do, but in the asset side, from the cash, we have detect the 4,000 rupees, because we have paid this amount a gift by purchasing the furniture. So we have deduct from cash $4,000 and add into the furniture account. So the first balance is in the cash account is $96,000 plus $4,000 for furniture equals capital $100,000. Both sides are balanced. Our next transaction third transaction is purchase goods for $25,000. This will also belong to a cash transaction. We have detect the cash from the cash account $25,000 and open a goods account and add $25,000 in the goods account. So we have first of all we have open a goods account and put into the $25,000 in it and detect $25,000 from the cash account. So now our balance is in our cash account $71,000 plus furniture $4,000 and goods $25,000 equals $100,000 for capital. Both sides are equal in the left hand side and right hand side. Now we have another transaction which is paid transportation on goods purchased $1,000. We have detect $1,000 from the cash and also detect the same $1,000 from the capital. So now you have seen you have detect $1,000 from the cash balance and also detect $1,000 from the capital because this amount is detecting from also capital. Now the balance is at the end of this transaction is in the cash account $70,000plus $4,000 for furniture and $25,000 for the goods equals to $99,000 for capital. Both sides are equal. After entering the each transaction, we also check the balance and add up we have seen that the both sides, left hand side and right hand side is equal and it must be equal. Whenever you seen that the left hand side is not equal to the right hand side, it means you are doing something wrong. Next transaction is sold goods for $15,000 costing rupees $11,000. This transaction is put into that manner. We have detect $11,000 from the goods and add the $15,000 in cash because we have received $15,000. So first of all we have added $15,000 in the cash account and detect the $11,000 from the goods account because we have failing the $11,000 goods. We have earned $4,000 profit and this will be added in the our capital. So we have added the $4,000 capital. The balance after passing entering this transaction is $85,000 in the cash account plus $4,000 in the furniture account and plus $14,000 in the goods account. On the right hand side 1,03,000 in the capital account. The next transaction is purchase goods on credit basis for $15,000. We have purchased goods from creditor or supplier on credit basis. It means that this transaction is credited transaction, not cash transaction for $15,000. It means that we have an amount of payable $15,000. We have increased our liability. In the liability side, we have opened an account named payables and written the value of $15,000 in it. But on the left hand side, from goods, we have added $15,000 because we have purchased goods from any person on credit basis of $15,000. At the end of entering this transaction, the balance is $85,000 in cash account plus $4,000 in the furniture account plus $29,000 in the goods account. On the right hand side, we have payables of $15,000 and plus 1,03,000 in the capital account. The next transaction is sold goods to Mr. Raza on credit basis for $8,000 costing $6,500. We have put this transaction in that manner. We are selling goods to Mr. Raza on credit basis. It means we are not receiving the cash. So we have not added the cash into the cash account. We have make an other account named as receivable. Receivables means that the we have received this amount in future after against the sale account on credit basis. In the receivable account, we have also written $8,000 and deduct the $6,500 from the goods because we have selling these goods and we have earned $1,500 as revenue or profit. This will be added to our capital. So we have added $1,500 in the capital. Now the balance is cash account $85,000 plus $4,000 in furniture account plus $25,500 in the goods account and $8,000 in the account receivable account. And on the right hand side, we have a balance of $15,000 in the payable account plus $1,04,500 in the capital account. And the next transaction in this regard is we have another we have add the previous balance in this slide, and we have now the transaction is received cash from Rashid $4,000. We have added this $4,000 into the cash account and deduct it from the receivable account, and in the receivable account we have receivable amount is $8,000, and now at the present time we have received only $4,000, so that we have deduct only $4,000 against the receivable account. Now the balance is at the passing of this transaction in the cash account is $89,000 plus $4,000 in furniture account plus $25,500 in the goods account and $4,000 in the receivable account. But on the right hand side, we have $15,000 against the liabilities plus $1,04,500 in the capital account. And the second last transaction is cash paid to the creditor is $9,000. We have the payable amount of $15,000. But at this time we have pay only $9,000. So the $9,000 is deduct from the cash account and also deduct from the liability side or the right side $9,000 from the payable account. Now the balance is at the end of this transaction is in the cash account we have only $80,000, in the furniture account we have $4,000, in the goods account we have $22,500, in the receivable account we have only $4,000, and in the right side we have payable amount is $6,000 and the capital is $1,04,500. We have now put the last transaction of this example. The last transaction is paid rent and salary from the month of June, $4,000. We have deduct the $4,000 from the cash account and we have also deduct this $4,000 from the capital account because we have reduced the capital account. $4,000 is deducted also capital account. Now the balance is in the cash account we have $70,000 in the cash account, $4,000 in the furniture account and $25,500 in the goods account and $4,000 in the receivable account. On the right hand side we have 6,000 against the payable account and 100,500 dollar in the capital account. So we have put or right over all transaction. We have now total the all balances which have cash plus furniture plus goods plus receivable. So the total is 106,500 dollar. On the right hand side we have also the same balance 106,500 dollar, and it must be same because we have passing all the entries accurately. This is our the main area, because in the last lecture we have also seen the accounting equation, that is if it is equal to liability plus owner equity. And now in this session we have seen an example and solve it in front of you. Now we have discussed an other topic in our today session is rules for debit and credit. We have also learned in the previous lectures if it's expenses, liabilities, equity and income. The rule for debit and credit for these transaction is very simple, because every transaction must be belongs to in these five categories. It must be belongs to effort, or either it must be belong to expensive, either it must be belongs to liability, or it must be belong to equity and income. So the rules for effort, expensive are same, and the rule for liability, equity and income are same. The rule for debit for the effort, when the effort is increases, it must be debited, and the one the expenses must be increases, it is also increase, it must be debited. When the effects and expenses will decrease, it will be credited. On the other hand, when the liabilities, equity and income are decreases, they will be recorded as debit balance. And when the liabilities, equity and income are increases, it will be credited. And if we talk about the normal balances of the asset, expenses, liabilities, equity and income, the normal balance of asset account is debited, and the normal balance of expenses account is also debited, and the normal balance of our liabilities, equity and income is credited. Because effort, when effects are increases, it must be debited, and when liability, equity and income is increases, it must be credited. So the normal balance is when the increases of effects, it will be treated as debit balance. Friends, this is our today's session. In the next session, we have also taken another example of rules and debited and credit. And from this example, we have tell you that how the effects will be increases, or how the liabilities will be increases, and how the liabilities will be increases and recorded as a credit. And I will tell you how the effects will be increases and written in the debited side. You can download our today session's example from the our website or another source. We have put the description, we have put a link of these file into the our description, and we also recommend you that you have download the example or problems from our link which is posted in the description. I hope you are enjoying and learning accounting. Thank you.